Okay, so you've read the question. We've got Adam, and he's chasing Mark. Mark is running at a constant velocity of 3. We've got 2 people in this question, so let's do 2 sets of givens. For Mark, his velocity, as I just said, was 3 meters per second. He's running at a constant velocity, which means the only variables we need are v, d, and t. I'm going to call that dm for Mark, tm, the time for Mark. But the only thing I know is 3, so let's hang on 1 second there, and let's look at Adam for a second. Adam starts from rest. Well, that means, of course, that V1 is equal to 0. And as soon as I write V1, I'm going to have to write V2. I'm going to write A. I'm going to write delta D. I'm going to write delta T. All 5 of the variables that belong to my kinematics equations, the big 5. So V1 for Adam is 0, and he's accelerating it set at 0.2 meters per second squared. And here I'm going to write dA and I'm going to write tA, the displacement of Adam and the time for Adam. The most common mistake for people who don't read the question very well and don't understand what they're doing is to go ahead and slap 30 meters as one of these distances. And then they solve something and say, is this right? And it's of course totally wrong. Because look back at the question. What was 30 meters? 30 meters is how far apart Adam and Mark are at the start, when t equals 0. Then at some point, Mark is going to keep on running, but at some point, Adam is going to speed up. And eventually, it won't take too long because Adam is much faster than Mark, but eventually they're going to be in the same place at the same time. And that's the end of the race. Adam is now caught up to Mark. 30 meters was only the head start. That's not what D in the big 5 stand for. Delta D with the little arrow. It stands for displacement, how far they actually went. So how far did Mark actually go, for example? Well, he started here and he ended up here. That is the displacement of Mark. What about Adam? Well, Adam started way over here. And he ran the 30 meters and he ran as far as Mark had to run. So we're going to call that DA. Now you can see the 30 meters, of course, is part of the question, but it's not one of the givens. The question's a little harder than that. What is the question? The question was to find dA. What is the displacement of Adam? So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to call that x. That's what we're trying to find. What is x? I'm going to call that x, so then over here I'm going to say x. Okay, if this is x and this is 30, then what's the displacement of Mark? It's obviously x, take away 30. X minus 30. And that takes care of the d's. The only thing left is the time. But we started at 0, and we caught up to them at a time of t. So the time for each of them is going to be t. Again, I'm not really using those little question marks because they don't help us figure out what formulas to use. I will use it, though, for v2 for Adam because I don't care what Adam's velocity is when he passes Mark, although if this was a test, I would probably make that part B of the question. So, looking at Mark again, we see, we know that displacement equals velocity times time. Subbing in, we see that x minus 30 equals 3t. Again, 2 equations, 1 equation, 2 unknowns. We can't solve that. We need another equation here. Looking at Adam, we see that d equals v1t plus 1/2 at squared. Subbing in again, v1 is 0, disappears, that's convenient. We see that x equals 0.1t squared. And I have taken a shortcut. I have not followed my own advice. I didn't show the substitution. I skipped a step. Hopefully I didn't make a mistake. Putting the two equations together, if I sub this equation into that equation, I will get that 0.1 t squared minus 30 equals 3t. Rearranging this, because it is of course a quadratic equation, I get that. I like to use my not super smart calculator, but pretty smart, it's not a graphing calculator, to answer that. It doesn't take very long, and I see quadratic formula that t is either 37.9 seconds or negative 7.9 seconds. Negative 7.9 seconds? Obviously that doesn't make a lot of sense, but it means if we took this person backed it up backwards in time, that's when we'd meet again. But it's nonsense as far as this question is concerned, so we're just going to stick with the 37.9. That means it took me 37.9 seconds, it took Adam rather, 37.9 seconds to catch Mark. How far did Adam go in that time? Well, we already know the formula for that. We're trying to find x, it's 0.1 t squared. If I square 37.9, multiply it by that, I get 143.6 meters. And that's how far Adam had to run. Mark obviously had to run 30 meters less because he had the head start.